latest start yet, 12:30. And yeah, so we hummed and hawed all morning because it's quite windy. We were nervous because the shoulder we have is so narrow, and the gusts were so strong, we didn't want to take the chance of getting pushed into the road. But we decided that they've calmed down a little, they're more westerly, so they're actually quite favorable. So we're going to give it a try, and if we think it is too dangerous, we'll cut the day short, but we're going to give it a go. We're aiming for 100 kilometers away from here, so yeah, hopefully it all goes well and the wind pushes us there. Okay, so we did get on our bikes today.
No, we didn't not ride.
We did not ride.
Never not ride.
Can't do it.
No rain, no wind. Will it ever stop us?
But now we're trying to find the mystery of what this Pokemon business is that we keep hearing about. But we're in the middle of nowhere, so nobody plays it here. Anyway, so yeah,
Pokemon Go.
How was the wind today?
Oh, the wind was just like the wind is every day. We like to talk about the wind and the weather all the time.
Yeah, hopefully it will stop one day soon. But anyway, it was not an issue today. We think the forest was so thick.
It was very thick forest.
There's less wind today than there was yesterday.
There was, and we're going to be in Thunder Bay tomorrow.
Woohoo! So that is our real rest day as planned.
Yeah, it seems like 2 minutes ago since our last rest day.
Yeah, it was. Wasn't that long ago.
It goes quickly. Mm. But I always think of Thunder Bay as this like made up place.
Because the name.
It's such a cool
Thunder
name.
Thunder Bay.
So, yeah.
Yeah, Nathan's got a theme song for it. He might sing it to you. Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, we're tucked into bed, did our 100k, had our dinner.
I've got a mosquito bite on my neck.
New one.
I'm resuming.
Anyway. So yeah, that's all for us today. I'll show you some footage of what the rain non-wind event was like.
The Enjoy. Rain and non-wind event. Exciting.
So a little example here today of the type of roads and hills in Ontario. As you can see, I can't zoom in, so it's a little up and down, up and down. So that makes it a little more interesting. Yeah, so we have a tailwind actually, so it's helping today, and we're almost halfway to Thunder Bay, which is good. These roads are harder work just because of the narrow shoulder, so we don't stop and film a lot, we're just concentrating on getting there alive. Alright, so we're in Thunder Bay having breakfast on a rest day. We're at the Scandinavian House. It's very friendly here. And we're having the $3.99 Monday to Friday early bird special. Yeah. Got some poached eggs, hash browns.
You've eaten the bacon.
I've already eaten the bacon. The roast bacon, bacon has it. Yeah. And then it's time for laundry. Here we go. To the laundromat. Oh, Nathan's been distracted by food. Bakery.
Stop filming, right?
All right, life is a bike tour. Into the laundromat. Action. Are they all dry? Wow.
Yeah.
Clean. Nathan is obsessed with smelling clothes right now.
Everything usually stinks.
It does usually stink. Alright, so we are hanging the clothes to dry now. the Canadian way on a proper clothesline. We have a cute little helper. Hello. A very sweet little puppy dog. We don't know his name. Hello.
I'm not familiar.
Alright. So we had a successful rest day. I'm just coming back from dinner at the tavern. Bikes, chains are sort of clean. Clothes are clean. We're clean. We're rested. Weather is beautiful today. Hopefully more of the same tomorrow. Although a little warmer would be good, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So yeah, successful rest day. I'll see you tomorrow.
So we've left Thunder Bay. Thunder Bay is done after having a nice rest in a hostel. We've just ridden our bikes off the highway, which was great, along a lakeside drive road, which was very nice indeed for the first 20k of our journey today. And then we're gonna have to join the highway again in a bit, which is a shame because it was lovely. So we just stopped off quickly outside a fire station, very randomly, and there's a very conveniently placed picnic table for us to sit on. We're enjoying some snacks and some water, and yeah, we'll hit the road. I think we're going to try and get to Nipigon today. It's beautiful today though, the sun's shining. Yeah, it's Saturday morning. The roads seem a bit quiet, which is nice. I hope it stays that way. Michelle's trying to even out her tan.
See my lovely tan.
She's got a tank top on to try and even it all out.
Yeah, it'll just make it worse, but...
Michelle's not happy now. She's not happy with the wind. She's sulking.
The wind makes me cold, but it makes me also feel like it's not summer.
The wind makes her cold, and it makes her also feel like it's not summer. But it's sunny.
It's a beautiful lake.
Look how lovely it is out here. I, for one, love the wind because it keeps those bloody mosquitoes away, so I'm happy about that. That's true love, that is. So she's sitting on the floor, blowing up the beds.
Hiding from the wind.
Hiding from the wind.
My bike is sheltering me.
I'm going to make her a nice dinner, though, of couscous with chicken stock and spring onions. Yay! In the fry, I got to go and get the ingredients from the most expensive store in the world. There only seems to be one here though, so. So yeah, setting up camp. It's beautiful around here.
We have the whole campsite for ourselves. $11.
It's stunning. So yeah, I think we should just enjoy what we've got, hey Michelle? And not worry about the wind. You gotta check this out as well. So this is beavers. Beavers at work and what they do. It's pretty incredible really. Look. So look, he's proper gnawed down this tree. It's a massive stump just left. They're little buggers, aren't they? I don't know where I don't know how recent that was or whatever. But it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Beavers. Beavers at work. Sorry, that was actually a mosquito on the camera then. It was going for me. It's today's episode of Michelle Makes Coffee. New coffee. Yummy.
Winnipeg coffee.
So it's nice and early. There's no one here. It's like bit of a graveyard. It's a bit weird. It's nice though because we had the whole place to ourselves, so we've just taken shelter because there might be some rain, so we can have breakfast and coffee, and then we're gonna make a move and we're going to try and get to Terrence Bay today. But I think it's gonna be really hilly, but it's also Rafa Women's 100 day, so we have to do 100k. The women do, so Michelle can go on, I can just stay somewhere else. So yeah, we're gonna have some coffee. We've had some granola. And then we're gonna crack on, get on with it, and we'll catch up with you in a bit.
Alright, so it's I said earlier, it is Rafa's Women's 100 Day. It's a day that women get out and ride 100 kilometers to encourage women to get involved in cycling and push themselves. It's a good initiative. I haven't yet been able to join in. The other days it was run, I wasn't near my bike or wasn't at home. So yeah, I'm not in the UK, but I'm in Canada, and I'm definitely going 100k today, because our next destination is Terence Bay, which is 107k, which is perfect. However, there's a lot of hills, so it'll be over 1,000 meters of climbing today. So we're going to get going, take it easy, hope the weather cooperates. It is quite cool, but with the climbing, that's a great thing, actually. So yeah, I've got my Rafa Women's 100 stickers on my bike, and I'm ready to go.
White walkers are coming. Foggy. It's very foggy. We're gonna put the flashy light on.
It's not bright enough.
Look, ready? You'll hear a car. And then a car will magically appear. Oi!
Finished our women's 100 ride. We got 105k, but then we broke into the emergency motel funds. I wasn't feeling very well yesterday at the end of the day, and I didn't sleep well, and I was just not feeling 100% today either. I don't think, not as bad as yesterday evening, but not 100%. So yeah, we were riding along. Today was about 10-12 degrees, so it was pretty cold. Then the last 30k, 40k, the fog rolled in, and that wasn't forecasted, so we were a bit surprised. And we literally, you'll see in the footage, or you've seen the footage, can't see 50 feet in front of the bike. Luckily we had a shoulder, so we weren't in the middle of the road or on the road. So yeah, we got to our destination 105k later, but we were cold, damp, wet, had enough. It was a bit of a slog today, a lot of climbing. So we just decided to treat ourselves, because as we pulled up to this motel next to the gas station, as skies had been darkening for the past half hour, it just opened up and poured down, and we literally just ducked under cover, got a little bit drenched, but not soaked through, and we decided since they had a room, we would stay. So yeah, that's where we are now, in the motel, enjoying hot showers, a dinner, beds. Catching up on the news. Yeah, so we're out again tomorrow morning. We should probably be wild camping the next two nights. And hopefully we'll also see some of the lake. We know there's a lake out there, but we couldn't see it because of the fog. We caught glimpses of it earlier today, and it's absolutely stunning. So we're hoping for some sunny weather tomorrow. Good morning. All right, so we had some nasty weather yesterday. We ended up at this motel, but turns out we have a lake view. So there's Lake Superior, we're in Terence Bay. There's a little bit of fog over there. Good morning. So we made it to Marathon, and a truck driver came up to us as we were going down a dirt road to warn us that there was nowhere to camp down there. I guess he recognized cycle tours, and he invited us to stay here in his backyard. So yeah, very lovely evening here. Nathan's just packing up. tent is drying. So yeah, we had a good evening, and we had company of two other bike tours, a girl from Quebec and a gentleman from France. So quite the international crew last night. And yeah, today no wind, lots of sun, we're happy. Our very idyllic spot. We had lunch, very lovely by the lake in the sunshine. Just packing up now. Yeah, it's absolutely stunning place to have lunch. Lake in the middle of nowhere. So yeah, we have another 40k to go, and then we'll be in White River, which is where Winnie the Pooh is from.
Where are we, Michelle?
We're at Winnie the Pooh. This is where Winnie the Pooh was found.
But what's it called?
It's called White River.
So yeah, we're at White River, where Winnie the Pooh, where it all began. So this is the hometown where the guy actually bought Winnie the Pooh and then went to England with him, which I didn't know.
And Winnie the Pooh is a girl.
Yeah, and Winnie the Pooh is actually a girl. So I didn't know. So dude after Winnipeg. So yeah, there's Winnie the Pooh in his tree. We're going to camp up here tonight and enjoy White River with Winnie the Pooh. It's pretty good. It's going to be really dark.
I can see you pretty well. I have the night setting. So,